When you are first starting out running your Bitcoin Lightning Network routing node, or just running a node in general because you want to receive payments, the most difficult hurdle for actually receiving or routing payments is inbound liquidity. The idea that in order to receive payments on Lightning Network, you need to have a channel with most of the Satoshis on the other person's side so that there is capacity to receive payment on the Lightning Network through that channel. Now, I'm not going to go into detail about how that works. Instead, in this video, I'm going to share with you about a dozen different ways for you to get liquidity fast so that you can start receiving and routing payments on the Lightning Network. Let's dive in. First, let's start out with the absolute free ways for those of you who want to spend a little bit more time or invest a little bit more energy, but you don't want to waste your precious Satoshis getting that inbound liquidity. Well, one of the first and lesser known ways is called ln2me.com, and they've essentially created a kind of roundabout weird way of opening a balanced channel. Effectively, all you need to do is open a channel directly to them and push 50% of the sats to them as you open the channel. Now, you have to be careful in doing this. There are very clear instructions on how it should be done. But effectively, once you open that balance channel, they will send you 50% of the sats back on chain, effectively doing what is called a loop out of 50% of the sats. And you will have a perfectly balanced channel wherein 50% of the Satoshis in the channel total are now inbound liquidity, really fast, really easy, really cheap, really affordable. So I recommend everyone start out by opening a balanced channel with LN2Me. The next one I want to talk about is probably my favorite one. It is absolutely the best way to double the amount of overall capacity when you are committing Satoshis, meaning if I have 10 million to put into channels, I can get 20 million in capacity, and that is Lightning Network Plus. Basically, this is a platform where you can organize Lightning Network swaps or rings. The idea behind this is really pretty simple. I open up to person B opens to person C opens to D, and D opens up a channel to me. Effectively, we all get double the capacity. We get as much inbound as we commit outbound, and it's a great way to get two times the bang for your buck. You can see here there are a ton of different swaps, although many of them do not follow my rules for the minimum channel size that I recommend opening. So make sure that you check out this video where I talk about the importance of Lightning Network channel size and what the minimums are. This is a great way, and I recommend you do a whole bunch of swaps if you want to connect with other plebs and you're not interested in getting a high ranking with good peers, although you can actually now specify that you only want peers of a certain caliber or a certain node size. On that note, let's talk about opening balanced channels or dual funded channels. One of the other great ways to get two times the bang for your buck and not commit as many Satoshis to channels that will have all those sats stuck on your side and therefore give you no inbound capacity is to negotiate opening balanced channels. Now, I previously did a video on this and you all love this video, so make sure to check out that video here. But essentially what I recommend doing is just joining some of the popular Telegram groups out there. I love the group Plebnet. I love Rings of Fire, and I've previously talked about those. I will link below. And also, just feel free to search around on Amboss or other Lightning Node explorers and find the Telegram names and handles of the people that you want to open channel with, and then simply contact them and say, hey, are you willing to open a balanced channel with me? People send me these requests on Twitter all the time. They send them to me on Telegram, and I'm usually pretty happy to comply, although if you're watching this right now, I don't have any more sats on chain, so you can just open a channel up to me, sorry. This is, like I said, a great way to get more bang for your buck, and when you're just starting out, I definitely don't recommend opening too many channels where all of the sats are on your side. There's just no reason when you could have a perfectly balanced channel and 50% of the sats you're committing could come to you on the inbound. Plus, you can open twice as many channels because it doesn't take nearly as much funds to commit. The next one is kind of a hack or workaround idea. It's kind of a makeshift loop out, and we're going to talk about in a second what that actually means. But what you do in this method is just open up a big channel to any exchange that supports Lightning Network. You can see here, there's a huge list of them. And then just send as many sats as you want to that exchange. If you're lucky, some of these exchanges won't charge anything for a Lightning deposit. And since you have a channel with them, they probably won't charge anything for a Lightning withdrawal. Worst case, you're looking to pay about 100 sats unless you're going to try and send it in a ring. Not the topic of today's video. Not going to explain what that's all about. But this is a great way if you just want to get some quick, very, very cheap liquidity. Open up a 10 mil channel to Bitfinex and then deposit all 10 million of those Satoshis in your exchange account. You could always withdraw them later over Lightning or over the main chain. So a really effective way. But like I said, these are not free. They know that this is a workaround. And so they do charge some fees, sometimes conversion or exchange fees. So beware of that and know what the fees are before you actually go ahead and deposit 10 million sats. Speaking from experience. The next way is, again, a really fantastic way if you just want to get some inbound capacity fast. Let's say, for example, you're about to launch a new product in your business, or you're going to put up a crowdfunding and some kind of donation page, and you just need a lot of inbound capacity very fast. And that is a whole new category of buying channels. Now, I previously did a video on this as well, giving you a walkthrough tutorial, but one of my favorite and newer ways of getting inbound liquidity is the Amboss Lightning Marketplace. Now, I won't go too much into how that works because, again, I did a whole tutorial on this, but basically all you have to do here is see the different offers and you can take someone up on their offer for a channel, pay them a small amount of sats, which you probably hopefully already have outbound liquidity because of all the other methods that I gave you for opening dual funded channels. And they'll just open up a channel to you. This is a really, really great way, again, if you're willing to spend a little bit and you just want to get some fast sats inbound liquidity. Other competitors to this include Lightning Labs Pool, which runs on your node. It's a bidding marketplace for opening channels. I've never been able to actually get it to work on my node, which is why I recommended Magma first. Additionally, if you say, hey, Jonathan, this is all cool, but I don't have time to mess around, shop different offers. I just want to buy a channel from a really good, reputable node that I'm going to be able to route a ton of sats through. Well, I have a couple solutions for you. First and foremost, Bitrefill Thor channels. You can simply buy a channel right here. It's not cheap, but you can buy huge channels and you just effectively tell them how much you want to pay. And apparently it is out of stock, so never mind on that one. But maybe when you're watching this video, there is a way for you to buy some inbound on Bitrefill. Not to worry though, because our friend Anonymous Super Whale LNBIG does allow you to purchase inbound channels as big as you want, including a full Bitcoin. Yes, you can buy a full Bitcoin inbound liquidity and it is only going to cost you $46. You probably don't need a full Bitcoin inbound liquidity. Sorry, I can't talk today. But you can, for 10 bucks, buy a Wumbo channel. So that's pretty cool. And I would recommend checking that out if you are willing to pay and you just need a ton of inbound from a really great source. And finally, last but not least, one of the more expensive ways I mentioned that you can kind of loop out using exchanges by just sending the funds. But there is actually a dedicated service. There are a few dedicated services, such as Bolts and other ones. But there is a dedicated service that will let you send funds from an existing channel that you have and loop them out and get them back on chain so you can use those funds to send out more channels and open more channels and expand your node's capacity. That service is called Loop and it is wildly expensive. I rarely, if ever, use it. But if you want to get the most bang for your buck with your sats or you have some channels already open, you don't want to just pay for channels and you want to move sats out of those channels to open new channels while also creating inbound liquidity. God, I hope I have not confused the hell out of you guys so far. Loop is the solution for you. Essentially, all you have to do with Loop is send them some sats from a channel and they will send them back to you on chain. You've now created inbound liquidity on that channel and you now have more sats on chain to open another channel. All right, those are my 6, 7, or 8 ways to create inbound liquidity on your node very quickly. If you have enjoyed this video, I encourage you to subscribe because I've got a whole gang of content about Lightning Network and running Lightning Network nodes coming out. Make sure that you also hit the bell icon so you don't miss any new videos. And if you really are feeling generous, feel free to send me a tip on Lightning Network. That's all for today. Thanks for watching and take care.